Hello everyone, I am Annika May L. Lapitan, and today I'm going to discuss about On Karma and Vedic hymns in India. So for the introduction, India has a rich tradition of spiritual beliefs and practices that date back thousands of years. Among these, the concept of karma and Vedic hymns hold significant importance. They form the foundation of many Indian philosophies and cultural traditions, influencing daily life, rituals, and social norms. So, sa India's spiritual heritage, ayun yung pinaka-oldest and most profound in the world dahil sa mga tradition and practices nila na na-evolve over thousands of years. So, yung central ng heritage nila ay yung concept ng karma and Vedic hymns kasi it plays a crucial role in shaping Indian thought and culture. And mamaya i-explain ko kung ano ba yung karma and yung Vedic hymns. So what is karma? Karma is a Sanskrit word that means action or deed. It refers to the idea that every action we take, whether good or bad, has consequences. These consequences can affect our present life or future lives or reincarnation. The belief is that good actions lead to positive outcomes while bad actions lead to negative consequence. So yung karma mula siya sa salitang Sanskrit na ang ibig sabihin ay action or deed. O sa Tagalog, ito yung gawa o kilos. Ibig sabihin nito, whatever we do, whether it's good or bad, it has consequences or result. So yung consequence na yon, nakaka-influence siya sa current life natin or future life. O mas pinaniniwala ang reincarnation ng mga India. So, sa madaling paniniwala sa karma, kapag mabuti yung ginawa mo, mabuti rin yung balik sa'yo. Pero kapag masama yung ginawa mo, negatibo rin yung magiging resulta. So, halimbawa, kapag tumulong ka sa isang tao na nangangailangan, o nagbigay ka ng pagkain sa nagugutom, so, possible na maaaring maranasan mo rin yung tulong na binigay mo mula sa iba kapag ikaw naman yung nangailangan. Pero, kapag nanloko ka ng ibang tao, nanakit ka, nagnakaw ka, nagsinungaling ka, lahat na ng masasama, eh yung magiging balik sa'yo ng karma is magiging masama sa current life mo or sa hinaharap. So, yung karma, it teach us na dapat maging maingat tayo sa mga ginagawa natin dahil may epekto to hindi lang sa ibang tao, kundi pati na rin sa sarili natin. Next is the beliefs of karma in Indian tradition. In India, karma is closely tied to the belief in reincarnation or the cycle of rebirth. It is thought that our actions in one life determine our fate in the next. This belief is part of many Indian religions, including Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, and Sikhism. It encourages people to live a righteous life and seek spiritual growth. So dito naman sa beliefs ng India, dito papasok yung karma na ang ibig sabihin is what goes around comes around. So ibig sabihin, gaya ng sinabi ko, if you do good deeds and live a kind, honest life, good things will come your way either in this life or the next. So on the other hand, kapag gumawa ka naman ng bad things, you may face the consequence later, even in your next life. So dito napapasok yung idea ng reincarnation na pinaniniwalaan nila na kapag namatay ka, yung kaluluwa mo will be reborn into a new body. So yung type of life na kinamulatan mo, it's either rich or poor, healthy or sick, happy or sad, is nakadepende siya sa karma na ginawa mo in your previous life. So yung belief na to is common siya sa religions like Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, and sa Sikhism. And next is the importance of karma in Indian tradition. So first is the reincarnation or samsara. Karma is integral to the cycle of rebirth. Good karma can lead to a favorable rebirth, while negative karma may result in challenges or hardships in the next life. So just like what I've said earlier, in Indian tradition, yung karma is connected siya sa reincarnation or also called as samsara. Siya yung cycle of birth, death, and rebirth. So, pinaniniwalaan to ng mga taga-Indian people, ng mga taga-India, na kapag namatay yung tao, yung soul nila is marereborn yun sa new body. And kung ano yung kamumulatan mo ulit na buhay, kapag nabuhay ka, is nakadepende yun sa karma mo from your past life. So, for example, kunyari, nung past life mo, mayaman ka, tapos, yung ginagawa mo naman is masasama, selfish ka, pwedeng kapag namatay ka, and nabuhay ka ulit, hindi na ganun yung buhay na kamumulatan mo because the outcome will be negative kasi pangit yung ginawa mo. Pero kapag nung past life mo is mahirap ka pero gumagawa ka pa rin ng mabuti, tumutulong ka, pwedeng in next life mo, kapag na reborn ka ulit, hindi na ganun yung buhay na kamumulatan mo. You can be reborn into a healthy and happy family. So, doon umiikot yung reincarnation and karma na sinasabi o pinaniniwalaan ng mga taga-India. And sundod naman dito is yung dharma or righteous duty. It's following one's dharma or moral and ethical duties is crucial in creating positive karma. It varies according to one's stage of life, caste, and responsibilities. So, yung dharma in Indian tradition, it refers to the moral and ethical duties that guide a person's action. So, yung pagsunod nila dito is importante kasi pinaniniwalaan nilang nagka-create yun ng positive karma. So, nag-iiba yung dharma ng tao depende sa person's stage of life, case, and responsibilities nga na sinasabi. So, for example, ang dharma ng student is mag-aral and respetuhin yung mga teachers nila. While yung mga adults naman, ang dharma nila is magtrabaho and supportahan yung pamilya. And ang dharma naman ng parents natin is alagaan tayo and in-nurture yung mga anak nila. So, sa India, pinaniniwalaan nila na kapag na-fulfill nila yung ganitong duties ng dharma nila is magke-create sila ng positive karma nga and na-connected siya sa reincarnation. Kasi living in this current life, they tend to create a positive karma para kapag na-rebirth ulit sila, is maganda pa rin yung buhay na kamumulatan nila. So, ayun nga, iba-iba yung dharma ng tao depende sa responsibilities and duties nila sa buhay. And nasa kanila na lang yun kung paano nila i-fulfill yung duties na yun. So, next is the examples of karma in Indian culture. In epic narratives, the Mahabharata and Ramayana are filled with stories illustrating how characters' action or karma directly impact their fates. For instance, in the Mahabharata, the actions of the Pandavas and Kauravas lead to triumphs and defeats that shape their destiny. So, the Mahabharata and Ramayana are two famous Indian epics that tell stories about how people's action or karma affect their future. So, sa Mahabharata, the actions of the two groups, which is Pandavas and Kauravas, is nagpakita sila kung saan sila dinala no choices na ginawa nila sa buhay. It's either success or failure. Gaya na lang ni Pandavas na he makes good and righteous decision which eventually lead to their success. While si Kauravas naman make wrong choices or decisions na naglead sa downfall nila. So, in stories na yon is nagsilbing aral siya sa mga taga-India na ano talaga nagiging epekto ng action and decisions na ginagawa nila na makakaapekto sa buhay nila sa hinaharap. Next is everyday practices. Acts of charity, kindness, honesty, and respect for elders are seen as ways to accumulate good karma. Daily practices such as donating food, volunteering, and helping the less fortunate are common. So, ayun nga, in Indian culture, pinaniniwalaan nila, if they do these everyday practices, is makakakuha sila ng good karma. Parang common na yon sa daily lives nila kasi parang ginagawa nila yon para makakuha ng positive outcomes sa hinaharap. Kasi parang natatakot silang mabalikan ng karma dahil nga, diba may pinaniniwalaan nga silang reincarnation. Na kapag na buhay ka ulit, kung ano man yung ginawa mo in your past life is
may consequence siya in your next life. So, ayun lang yung sinasabi dito sa everyday practices. And next is the religious rituals and festivals. Participation in festivals like Diwali, where good triumphs over evil, and rituals like pujas, where offerings are made to deities, as seen as action that can purify one's karma. And dito naman, naniniwala sila na if they take part in religious rituals and festivals, is mahe-help yun para ma-purify yung karma nila. So example, during sa Diwali, yung festival na nagsiselebrate ng good over evil, yung mga tao is nagpe-perform sila ng rituals and nagsiselebrate sila na nagsisimbolize sa triumph of righteousness. So, similarly sa pujas or religious ceremonies, kung saan yung mga tao is gumagawa sila ng mga offerings as a way of showing respect and seeking blessing. So, yung act na yon is pinaniniwalaan nilang ways para ma-improve yung karma ng isang tao and nagbibring pa siya ng more positive energy sa buhay nila. And now, let's proceed to Vedic hymns. So, what are Vedic hymns? Vedic hymns are ancient religious songs and prayers found in the Vedas, which are sacred texts of Hinduism. The Vedas were composed between 1500 to 500 BCE and are written in Sanskrit. These hymns are used in rituals and ceremonies to invoke the blessings of various deities such as Agni, the god of fire, Indra, the god of thunder and rain, and Sarasvati, the goddess of wisdom. So, ayun nga, sa India, yung Vedic hymns is isa siyang ancient religious song and prayers na nire-recite nila yung hymns na yon during religious ceremonies para i-honor yung mga gods and goddesses, gaya na lang nila Agni, the god of fire, ayun nga, ni Indra, the god of rain and thunder, ni Sarasvati, the goddess of wisdom and knowledge, para humingi sila ng protection and blessings. So, the example of a Vedic hymn is the Gayatri Mantra. It's one of the most famous Vedic hymns. So, ito yung Gayatri Mantra. Ang sabi dito is, Om Bhur Bhuvansva Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Divo Yona Prakodayat. So, yung prayer na to is kinoconsider siya for enlightenment and spiritual awakening. And natagpuan nila to sa Riveda, yung one of the four Vedas, and dedicated siya to the sun god, which is si Savitar. And yung mantra na to is often chanted during prayers, meditation, and rituals. And pinaniniwalaan ng mga taga-India na nakaka-purify ng mind, body, and soul na nagbibring or nagdadalas ng, sa mga tao na mas mapalapit sa divine wisdom or si God and understanding. So, ayun siya. Ayun yung Gayatri Mantra. The role of Vedic hymns in Indian tradition. Vedic hymns play an essential role in the rituals of Indian life. They are recited during religious ceremonies such as weddings, births, and festivals to bring prosperity, health, and spiritual benefits. The hymns are seen as powerful tools for connecting with the divine and bringing positive energy. So, ayun nga, yung Vedic hymns have a significant role in Indian tradition, especially sa mga religious and spiritual practices nila. So, yung hymns na yun is kinoconsider nilang sacred and powerful, that serving them as a medium to communicate with the divine or God. So, nire-recite nga nila to during various important life events, gaya na lang ng weddings. Nire-recite nila yung Vedic hymns para ma-bless yung couple for prosperity or prosperous and harmonious marriage. So, sa births din naman, nire-recite yung hymn na to welcome the newborn and pray for the health, wisdom, and protection. And also sa mga festival, gaya ang sinabi ko anina, during religious celebrations, Vedic hymns is sung para i-honor yung God and goddesses to ask for blessing like happiness,
wealth, and success. Cultural significance of Vedic hymns. Vedic hymns also play a role in preserving Indian traditions and heritage. They are passed down orally from one generation to the next, showcasing the importance of preserving language, music, and spiritual practices. The chanting of these hymns promotes mindfulness and the sense of community.
So, Vedic hymns have great cultural significance in India as they are integral to preserving the country's ancient traditions, language, and spiritual practices. And especially, it has been passed down through generations to generation, mainly through oral transmission. So, nakakatulong yun para ma-maintain nila yung authenticity and ma-continue yung hymns na yun for thousands of years. So, nagpre-preserve yun or nakaka-contribute ang Vedic hymns sa cultural preservation dahil sa pag-preserve ng language. Diba nga, kasi yung hymns ng Vedic hymns is nakasulat siya in Sanskrit, which is an ancient language. So, by learning and reciting these hymns, people keep the Sanskrit language alive, ensuring it is passed on to the future generations. So, when it comes to preserving music and rituals naman, is, diba yung hymns nga, it is often chanted in a specific melodies and rhythms, making them an essential part of India's musical heritage. So, yung proper pronunciation nun and rhythm is important talaga. Kaya talagang tinuturo yun ng mabuti ng mga taga-India. Sa spiritual practices naman, yung Vedic hymns nga, diba, tied siya sa India's spiritual and religious traditions. Kasi nga, parang yung true Vedic hymns, mas napapalapit yung tao sa divine God. And ginagamit nila yun sa mga rituals, which is central to Indian religious life. So, by keeping these practices alive, the hymns continue to offer a way para ma-honor yung gods and to seek blessings and para ma-deepen yung spiritual understanding nila. Next, how karma and Vedic hymns connect. Karma and Vedic hymns are interconnected in the way they both aim to create harmony and balance in life. The recitation of Vedic hymns is believed to create positive energy, which in turn supports good actions and intentions. Reinforcing the idea of good karma, both concepts emphasize living with integrity and seeking spiritual progress. So, nag-i-interconnect yung dalawa in a way na they both focus on creating balance and harmony in life. Kasi, di ba yung karma, it refers to the idea that our actions, whether good or bad, leads to corresponding results, shaping our future. So, ayun nga, when we perform good actions with pure intentions, we create positive karma. Similarly, kapag nire-recite ng mga taga-India yung Vedic hymns, is pinaniniwalaan din naman nila yon na nagja-generate ng positive energy, which nagsusupport siya ng good actions and intentions na nag-a-align siya sa principles of good karma. So, yung parehong yon, both of them emphasize living with honesty, integrity, and nagpo-focus sa spiritual growth. And ang goal is makakreate ng life of peace, balance, and moral progress. So, para mas madali nyo maintindihan, yung karma and Vedic hymns is pareho silang nagke-create ng positive karma. Pareho nung pinaniniwalaan ng mga taga-India na nagke-create ng positive karma. Kaya connected silang dalawa. And for the conclusion, karma and Vedic hymns are fundamental to understanding Indian culture and spirituality. Karma teaches the importance of actions and their consequences, while Vedic hymns helps maintain spiritual connection and invoke divine guidance. Together, they provide a framework for leading a meaningful and balanced life, emphasizing values that shape Indian society and culture. So, ayun nga, yung Vedic hymns and karma is central sila when it comes to understanding the essence of Indian culture and spirituality. And para mas maintindihan nyo, yung karma is ine-emphasize niya yung connection between sa action and consequences na ginagawa ng mga tao. And nagtuturo siya ng importance of moral responsibility and intentional living.
While the Vedic hymns, it helps to maintain spiritual connection and invite divine guidance. So together, Karma and Vedic hymns, they both offer a path for living a meaningful and balanced life, promoting values such as integrity, yung mindfulness, yung spiritual growth na nagsishape sa Indian society and culture. And that would be all. Thank you.